2372, a crap space commando unit were sentenced to a moon-based prison for crimes they didn't commit. They accidentally escaped from this military stockade to the spacefaring underground. Today, still wanted by the galactic government, they survive as space soldiers of fortune. If you have a problem, if no one else can help, and if you can find them, why the hell would you hire Aidan 7?
We meet again!
So, Kaiser von Nasty, my arch nemesis, face off this time to the death. Who'd have thought that once we were academy roommates set upon that path of lifelong friendship, then a woman came between us. We were sworn enemies. Of course, there was that lab accident that left you hideously disfigured, your hair sculptured into a permanent wave that meant that you had to buy extra stronghold hair gel and it was very expensive. And you then decided you would hunt me down through time and space. Me, through time and space, and kill me? Whilst at the same time trying to plot to overthrow the government and set yourself up as dictator over all the universe? God. You'll never do it.
Thank you for that plot filler. But now, you must prepare to die!
It's stop your grinning and drop your linen.
I shall win this battle, for I am the commander of Aidan's Seven. This situation requires us to think outside the box. Okay. It's time to use the Aidan maneuver.
But we don't have time to get it going.
Ah, you half-witted simian, the Aidan space maneuver. The fiend! Come, my insignificant little proletariat! It's time for me to lead you into battle, where I will then promptly, strategically, and cleverly wander off when things get a bit nasty.
E.T. phone home.
Come, it's time to finish off my arch-nemesis once and for all.
Until next episode, where he turns out miraculously not being killed in the last episode at all. Don't be so negative, Dr. Cyclops.
Don't look at me, I'm not even in this scene.
Come now, into battle.
There he is.
No, that's a rock.
How come he's got a moustache then?
Maybe because it's a rock face.
That's unexpendable. Nice of you to make it.
I do what I do. No more, no less.
Dr. Cyclops, where is Commander Aidan?
Yes, just where is Commander Aidan? Has he been trapped in a temporal vortex or transported to an evil universe facing harrowing suffering and adversity?
Hey, baby.
Meanwhile, back at the planet.
No kiss hello?
You know where my ass is, Kaiser.
Is your commander so scared of me that he sent his minions
to do his bidding?
Ha! At this very moment, he's devising a cleverly fiendish plan to defeat you once and for all.
So there I was, facing off against Godzilla, when I took him out in a very suave, stylish sort of way. I heard some photos back at my house, if maybe you want to come and have a look.
Meanwhile, he's still a bit alive. What? It's no henchman, Kaiser?
The rendezvous!
We've got to distract him somehow.
Look! Over there!
Bugger!
Nothing below the belt this time.
Funny, my wife says the same thing.
Bongo!
I'm sorry, I forgot I had this. Now, prepare to die!
Will our heroes be able to get out of this one? Will they be able to defeat the evil nemesis and return to the ship? Where did Commander Aidan get to? Did he get into her pants? Will the acting ever improve? Will the sets? When do they afford color? When will they ever get a chick on board? And will Bungo ever get laid? All these questions and less will be avoided next time in the mildly annoying and rash-inducing episode of Aidan 7! We'll be right back.